welcome to In Focus. It's been a fantastic start to the season, with the Swans currently fourth in the Barclays Premier League with 8 points. And following a blistering start to his Swans career, Andre Ayew was named Top Flight Player of the Month for August. Next up, it's an away trip to Vicarage Road, where the Swans will aim to pick up where they left off prior to the international break. Here's our match preview to this weekend's game. Up next, Swans right back Kyle Naughton gives his take on the start of the season, the unity within the squad, and the trip to Watford this weekend.
Yeah, I mean, after the pre-season we had as well. Last minute we ended up going to Germany, but everyone got a lot of game time, but me myself got quite a bit of game time, played a few 90 minutes, and then as a team we've just gone into the season all guns blazing. I mean, we've done quite well up to now, drawn one game, which at Sunderland was a good game. We thought we could have won it, but take a point there and then come back in and get three against Man United. When I first come here, straight away you do recognise that we are a good team. We are a good team. We've got some good players, got some good individuals, but more of a team for me than anything. It just works, you know, as a team. And I mean, when you've got something like that, it's just great to play in. But like I said, when you've got a team that works for each other and fights for each other and everything, it just shows. But I'm not surprised at all that. Just hopefully we can keep it on throughout the season. We're doing well, we've got a good understanding, but I think it's just how well everyone gets on with each other. Do you know, sometimes you might go to a club and there's two or three people that don't really speak to anyone or outcasts or anything, but I haven't seen that here. And I think that's part of the reason, like you say, as a back four, I wouldn't like to really say as a back four, it's more of a team. But from a back four, I mean, it's really understanding, and I think that's because we're working on it so much in training. you know, and the gaffer sometimes will take the back four away and do individual work with the back four, so that's going well as well. I think they've signed a whole new team. I think they've just gone out and signed a whole new team, which quite a few teams, when they come up to the Premiership, go out and buy a whole lot of players, but they seem to be doing all right. I mean, I don't think they're conceding, so straight away we're going to have to look how we're going to work on getting the ball in the back of the net. But I think in the Premiership, I don't think, especially now, you'll see like Leicester at the top and you'll see Chelsea down near the bottom. I don't think there is any easy games, and so we'll be going there with the same attitude as we did against Man U at home or Sunderland away, and just trying to get the job done. But I would say they're a good team. I'm not too sure how much I know about them yet until we play against them. But anything can happen. Anything can happen.
In our new segment called Dressing Room Tales, we get the insight into the goings-on inside the dressing room over the years, as told by the players themselves. This week, it's Alan Curtis with one of his stories.
Yeah, I mean, the dressing was full of characters. I mean, I have to say that, you know, when I first came, that probably the biggest influence, certainly probably in my career, apart from maybe my parents, was probably Harry Griffiths, because I actually sort of shared digs with Harry, and Harry did everything at the club. He was an ex-player, he was a coach, he was a physio, he was a scout, became caretaker manager, became manager, but he did everything at the club. And I mean, Harry sort of, he liked to drink, he liked to bet, and he liked to fag. And of course, when I first got into the first team, then I was actually, because I was in digs with Harry, meant that I could never come back. If we came back from an away game, then I was never able to go straight back home, because that would mean that Harry would have come home as well. So I spent many an hour sort of sat on the edge of the old townsman, sort of sat there with half a beer, but sort of Harry danced the night away, then eventually he sort of picked me up and then we'd disappear. But there were so many stories with Harry in particular. The Vetch in those days was like an open house. I mean, everybody came in there for treatment. You know, the local football players, cricketers, golfers, boxers, you name it, any sport. If they had a little bit of an injury, Harry would treat them. And of course, where we were situated was directly opposite the prison. I remember one time when the warden's coming in, I'm in a bit of treatment, and asking Harry, would there be any chance, could you come over and speak to some of the inmates, like a cross-section? So, you know, they arranged a date, Harry's gone over, parked the car by the Vetch, walked around, you know, did his sort of question and answer thing with the inmates, walks back to the car, realises can't find his keys, he might have locked him inside the car. So he's had to go back, knock the gates again, explain, you know, what's happened, that he's locked out, and, you know, could they help type of thing? And obviously, you know, there was bound to be a couple of people inside who would probably get into a locked car. So they pull this young boy out from the prison. He sort of walks back around, tells Harry how much he enjoyed the question and answer, and Harry explains the position, no problem. Sort of walks around the car, yes, Harry, not a problem at all. Bends down, picks a brick up and smashes it through the windscreen. And I think the poor boy, you know, I think he had another 6 months on top of his sentence. But it was just the type of things that there always seemed to be lots and lots of things going on, you know.
So that's it for another episode of In Focus. Join us again next week when we look ahead to the Everton match here at the Liberty.